Hello everyone, myself Samprit Patel, Assistant Professor from Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to see the second type of collection data types, that is tuples. After this session or video, you will be able to understand the second type of collection data types in Python and you will be able to apply tuples in different applications. So, starting with the introduction of tuples, tuple is a sequence of immutable Python objects. Immutable Python objects means once the tuple has been defined, you cannot change the elements in a tuple. So this is the basic difference between a tuple and a list. That is, lists are mutable, that is the content or the elements of the list can be changed, whereas the elements of the tuples cannot be changed. And the lists are enclosed in square brackets, whereas tuples are enclosed in parentheses. So see the following example. There are three tuples that we have defined: tuple 1, tuple 2, and tuple 3. So you can see tuple 1 contains string values as well as numeric values. Tuple 2 contains the same elements, that is the numeric values, and tuple 3 contains characters. So like list, tuple can also contain multiple element types or data types in a single tuple list. So syntax of creating tuple is tuple name, which is equal to tuple element 1 and 2 enclosed in single quotes and separated by commas. This is the one way you can define a tuple. And the second way to define a tuple is enclosed into round brackets, that is parentheses. We'll see an example of creating a tuple. So say tuple 1 is equals to, without using any parentheses, we will say ABC, and another element will be PQR, okay? And the second tuple will be tuple 2, which will be enclosed in parentheses, and the elements will be in single quote, that is say DEF and separated by commas, say X, Y, and Z. So we'll print both these tuples. So print tuple 1 and print tuple 2. So we'll run this code and see. Okay, so see, this is the tuple 1, that is ABC and PQR, and this is tuple 2, DEF and X, Y, Z. So the output you will see, even if we define without parentheses, the output will be with parentheses, which denotes that this is a tuple. So moving forward is concatenating. So before going to concatenation of tuples, we'll see two things: how to find whether the element is present in a tuple or not. So we'll just clear this print statement and say if, so using if statement into double quotes, if ABC in tuple 1, so this indentation is important in Python, so we'll say print in double quotes ABC is present in tuple 1. Okay, so using if statement and directly using an element to check whether it is present in a number or not, so it will give this particular statement. Now another thing is, if you want to find out the length of the tuple, so you can use the length len function, that is length of, say we'll find out the length of tuple 2. Okay, so this is the syntax for this. So see, the number of elements present in tuple 2 are 2, and that is the output of this particular print statement. Okay, so we can concatenate two different tuples. So for example, this is tuple 1 and tuple 2 we have defined, and we are printing both the tuples together using plus operator, that is used to concatenate two different tuples. We'll see the example with the same tuples that we have defined, that is tuple 1 and tuple 2. So if you want to print both together, it is like just tuple 1 plus tuple 2. Okay, so this is one way we can concatenate a tuple. So see, first we are getting ABC and PQR, and then we are getting DEF and XYZ. This is one way to concatenate a tuple. Another way is create a new tuple and assign the two tuples to this, tuple 1 plus tuple 2, and just print tuple 3. Okay, so it will give you the same output, okay, ABC and PQR. Now the third important thing is, you have seen how to add an element in a list, but being a tuple, we cannot add an element to a list. For example, if you want to add in tuple 1 index number 1, you want to add an element. So if we say LMN, okay, so this is defining the tuple 1 at the index location 1, we have to add LMN. So if we run this code, you will get an error saying that tuple object does not support item assignment. That is, you cannot add element to a tuple once it is defined. Okay, moving forward, take a minute and try to code the following problem statement. Write a program that contains two tuples, student details and student marks, and concatenate these details and marks of the student and display it. Okay, so as we have seen, so we'll change the values of, so we'll take student details, that is first tuple. We'll define this tuple as, say, student name will be ABC, its roll number will be 1, its department will be computer science and engineering, and the college will be WIT Solapur. So we cannot give this comma, as comma is used to separate two elements, so we'll say WIT. Okay, now we'll take second tuples for marks. So marks will be all integer numbers, so we can directly give, say, 50, 52, 60, after that 45, and say 70. Okay, so we have to concatenate. We have seen two methods, so we'll say, use the second one, say we'll display is equal to student details using plus operator marks, and we'll just write print display. So I guess there is a spelling mistake. So print display, okay. So we'll run this code. Okay, so the student details are displayed, the name, roll number, department, college, and the marks of 5 subjects. So these two different tuples have been concatenated. Now this is the answer. If you want to see, this is another possibility how we can concatenate two tuples. We have directly used print statement, and we have used operator sign between two tuples in print statement itself. Now nesting a tuple. So if you see the syntax, there is tuple 1 which have two elements, and there is tuple 2 which have two elements. So tuple 3, we can directly pass the two element, two tuples in it. So we'll see this example. So see, we have seen, we'll take the same example and we will insert these tuples as a tuple element. So student details comma So we have to give this in quotation marks. Okay. And marks. Okay. So we'll print display. Okay. So see, we have used quotation marks, therefore it is taking as a tuple element and not the tuple itself. So now if we remove the code and we'll run, now see, these tuple elements, the tuple element of student details and marks have been automatically assigned to display. Okay. Now deleting a tuple. If you want to delete a tuple completely, you can use a keyword del, that is DEL, and you can delete the complete tuple. So we'll say here del display and we'll run. You will definitely get an error that name display is not defined as you have deleted the tuple, right? So print statement won't be executing. So these are some references I've used to create this particular video and presentation, Programming in Python 3 of Pearson Publications and Core Python Programming of DreamTech Press. You can also go through these books if you have any doubts about it. Thank you.